Hey guys, so today I am sounding so stuffy, minding my business, sick at home, and I see that there's a new video with Selena Gomez, a new music video. So I said, let me just go ahead and do a reaction. Haven't heard any songs from her in quite a long time. I'm not a major fan or anything, but I have followed her story. You know, her breakup relationships, I'm a little bit aware of it. So I'm gonna have my box of tissues nearby. And I'm going to have my cup of tea with honey, and I have a cold right now, so I need to clear up my voice from time to time. So it's a different kind of video than what I normally do on this channel. I even found out about it because on my TV, you know, once you turn on these smart TVs, like, there's different recommendation, and I saw YouTube just kept recommending a video, and I saw 27 views, and it was one day ago. I'm like, what video is that? And I saw Selena Gomez. I said, oh, let me check it out, and I checked it out. I was like, wow, this song is amazing. So this is gonna be a video that's way different from what I normally do on this channel, so just stick with me. Comment down below your opinion about the song, and also don't forget to subscribe and like the video. You promised the world and I fell for it. Put you first and you adored it. Set fire to my forest. Oh wow. This is pretty interesting. I really like the black and white background. I went ahead and I paused it. I really like the black and white background, simply because I feel like it makes the video a little bit more emotional, and you can feel, you know, more sensitivity from the black and white background. Off key in my chorus, cause it wasn't yours. I saw the signs and I ignored it. Rose colored glasses are distorted. And I like how she's really honest about how she saw the signs and she's ignored it. I mean, this video is absolutely relatable to just about anybody. I mean, guy, girl, I'm sure everyone at some point has had their heart, you know, broken. And I'm sure everybody can just about relate to what she's talking about. Giving your heart to someone and then, you know, getting it broken, basically. And I think she's throwing, like, a lot of subtle shade in here, which is good because, like, you know, in this entertainment world, you, when someone does something to publicly, like, disgrace you or, you know, deface your name, you want to, you know, give recognition of it without giving the person too much credit. Out of my purpose, and I let it burn. You got off in the hurting when it wasn't yours. That's deep. That's really deep. I needed to lose you to find me. You know, like, I honestly can understand where she's coming from with this, because it's like sometimes when you're in a relationship, you have to be careful not to lose yourself in order to make the relationship work. It's like an identity struggle. And you always want to put yourself in a position where you know who you are and you're able to mesh who you are within the relationship. This dancing was killing me softly. I needed to hate you to love me. I love how she said how she has to hate you to love me. Sometimes you really have to, like, put your own needs ahead of everybody else in order to do well. Like, you can't always go around putting everybody ahead, because when you do that, it's like, who's gonna take care of you? And I think she's acknowledging that in this video. And it takes a lot of courage to come out and acknowledge that I needed to be a bit selfish in order for me to heal. And then she goes further to like admit, I gave my all. Like, how many of you comment down below feel like you're like the giver in a relationship? It could be a romantic relationship. It could be a friendship. You feel like you give so much and you're always the one that people come and take from you. And yet they never give back to you. I find that a lot, especially like female friendships that I have. I feel like people tend to come for advice and, you know, they take from you. And when it's like, it's time when I need you, it's like you're nowhere to be found. You'll tear me down and not show when you replace us. Ooh, I think that was a low-key shade when she said 2 months you replaced us. Then we all know who she's talking about. Like it was easy, made me think I deserved it. And I think of healing. Yeah, we'd always go into it blindly. I needed to lose you to find me. Can we take a moment and just talk about her vocals? Like, this girl can really sing. I mean, I really find it interesting that she mentioned I needed to hate you to love me. Sometimes hate is a good defense mechanism to help you get over someone that has hurt you so much. And it works. It works. I've had situations with friends where they've hurt me so bad and I had to resort to hate in order to get over them. And then once I got over the friendship, it's like, okay, now I have a clean heart about you. But I needed that like hate at the moment to get over you, kind of thing. Look at the layers. I like how the video is like filmed in like different layers, like layers on top of layers. It shows like these are the layers of me and I'm bare face. You know, the black and white like shows like emotional. It makes it more emotional and it shows like, oh, this is bare face. I'm here. I am an open book to you guys right now. And then she admits that this is goodbye for us. Sort of like, now I did my shade. I let you know how much you hurt me. And I've accepted that I'm done with you. This is amazing. This is a pretty interesting video. Good job, Celine. Guys, I really feel like crap. So that was the end of the video. If you like it, comment down below. Let me know what you think about the video. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button below and click the bell so that you are notified whenever I upload a video. Till next time, bye.